mean, it's surreal the way the whole thing went down. And by the way, I enjoyed listening to you guys tremendously. In the span of a few seconds, I learned so much more. But it's, you know, the whole, just the day, the anniversary of my injury, where Alex was hurt on the field, the type of injury it was. I never really saw mine. And I saw a quick shot of Alex's leg, and I turned to my wife, Robin, and I said, you know, it's just like mine. And I turned away and sort of got sick. And then you have those flashbacks to that particular night. It never goes away. It stays with you. But, you know, my heart and prayers and thoughts go out to Alex, because I know the road ahead. You know, I was 35, he's 34. It doesn't get any easier the older you get. And, you know, but medical science has changed a lot. Therapy has changed. The technology available to be able to do things has changed in 33 years. So hopefully he'll get a chance to come back.
You think he will?
I think he'll try, for sure. I mean, I don't know the severity of the injury. You know, he had surgery yesterday, from what I understand. I had an open compound fracture, and one of the biggest concerns with my leg was the exposure to the dirt. So they really wanted to make sure I didn't have an infection occur and something more drastic happen. I've spoken to different people who have had similar injuries to mine with open fractures, and they wound up taking the lower part of their leg to prevent, you know, the body from, you know, basically taking over. So, you know, I was very blessed and lucky to be able to do the things I was able to do. It's a struggle to come back, because it is your plant leg. That's the other thing. It's your right leg, your right-handed quarterback, and that's where the power comes from. So, you know, it's just the ironies. I have a nephew who's 33 years old, and his name is Alex Smith.
Oh, yeah.
The score of the game was the same score of our game, 23-21, except, you know, we came back and won. I mean, it just, the whole situation, it's eerie in itself.
Yeah, it sure is. Let's make a turn, if we could, and talk some stocks, as you and I often do. How's the market look to you as avid of a trader as I know you now are? What do you feel about the market today?
I think you have to be a little bit cautious with what's going on. Obviously, internationally, we're affected by things. Oil prices have come down. That's sort of why I like the airlines a little bit. I think the oil, you know, when oil prices come down, the airlines seem to do well. You're coming into a time of year when there's going to be a lot of travel. You know, and some of the energy stocks like Pioneer, for example, has come down a little bit. You know, again, going back to, you know, the airlines, you take a look at Southwest has come down a bit. And then I still think that down the road, not now, but down the road, the cannabis stocks are mostly Canadian, you know, Tilray and Canopy Growth. Those are things that I'm looking at. I went through that period where, you know, everybody was all excited about it when Canada passed it. We just saw, I think, Michigan approved recreational. It's a part of life. I mean, it will be here. Once the federal government realizes how much money is being left on the table that they can get their hands on here in the United States, I think things will change.
Are you? Let's go to the airlines first. I want to. You mentioned Southwest. I understand you. Are you buying Delta? From what I hear,
I am buying Delta.
It's funny because Credit Suisse had an upgrade of that stock today at Outperform, and they called it an industry bellwether. $71 is the price target. It's at 55 and change as we speak.
Yeah, I like, you know, I think it's very well run. It's very well run. I mean, you can look at all the different airlines. I like the price where it is. And, you know, I normally don't, you know, we've talked a lot. I like stocks in a little bit lower range. But when you look at what's going on, like I say, you look at the holidays, you look at the travel by everyone, you know, you look at the price of oil. I mean, they made a killing. You know, basically what the airline stock did by charging you for bags is what McDonald's did when they decided to have breakfast all day. I mean, it just changed the landscape of the stock tremendously.